in the period of Patanjali is actually not known. Some says that he lived in 5th century BC. Some says 3rd century. Some says in the 1st century. Some says in the early period of the Christian era, like 1st or 2nd century. And some even came with the idea that he lived in the 4th century AD. And nothing is sure. Anyway, that doesn't matter. That matters very much is his text and the content of the text. And it's very valuable, and he proposed the philosophy of yoga. So he is considered as the father of yoga. Thirumoolar also lived at the same time. He made his book, Thirumandira, which is also the basic text of yoga. Probably Thirumoolar's work might have taken longer time because it has 3,000 verses. Whereas Patanjali's book, only he streamlined the principles, it's 196 aphorisms. So probably Patanjali's work might have been the first work which came. He was born and lived in Chidambaram. Chidambaram is in Tamil Nadu. And there is a very famous temple. And inside the temple, there is a place devoted for Patanjali and Thirumoolar. These were two great names in the science of yoga. And both are talking almost the same thing. So it is considered that both these masters were having a common master. That idea was generally accepted because they were talking the same thing. Thirumoolar has elaborately discussing about the yoga system. Patanjali streamlined the principles only. Patanjali Sutras are very, very abridged versions, small lines, like two lines actually. And many times it is difficult to understand, so it requires interpretation by one who has studied it and practiced it in his life. There is a story behind the birth of Patanjali. Patanjali is considered as the incarnation of Ananda. Ananda is the serpent, the thousand-footed serpent on which Lord Vishnu was lying. These are stories. You just take it as a story. It communicates something, that's all. And there is one story which says that a group of humans went to see Lord Vishnu. And they wanted to know the secret of existence and yoga. So they went there and they asked him to apprise them of the basic principles of living, to emancipate. The Lord Vishnu said, "Well, becoming a person, and he will narrate all these things to the world, to the humans." And that person was Patanjali. This is a story commonly taught. Then there is another story. When Lord Vishnu was always, Lord Vishnu always was on the serpent Ananda. Ananda is the bed of Lord Vishnu. Ananda has 1,000 hooks. And while Ananda was carrying Vishnu, one day he felt the weight of Lord Vishnu was increasing like anything. that it became unbearable for Ananda to hold. And somehow he managed to hold the God of existence. Then after a while, the weight slowly reduced and it became normal. So Ananda asked to Lord Vishnu, "I had a strange experience because your weight increased like anything and it was so unbearable for me. And finally, the weight started to reduce and became normal. What is that actually? How comes such an experience came to me?" So he said that, "I was watching the dance of destruction, the Tandava dance of Lord Shiva. It was the dance of cosmic destruction. It's a very powerful dance, and the energy of the dance of destruction was absorbed by my body, and that was the reason why the weight increased like anything." So he got curious, Ananda got curious, and he asked, "Is there a possibility for me also to see this dance, Shiva's dance?" So he said, "Yeah, you will get the chance in your next life." This is the story behind. And then he was born later as the son of Gonika, a woman, an old woman. This lady was a very great devotee of Lord Vishnu, and she lived her whole life in devotion. She had the feeling to have a baby, and never she got. Now she was old, and she still do have that feeling of having a baby. One day when she was taking bath in the river, after the bath, in the Indian custom, they take some water in their hand, and feeling that this is the water, this is me, and then they identify with the water and pour the water back to the water source as union takes place there. So when she was holding the water in her palms, Anjali means palm, and she heard a sound, and she opened her eyes and looked. There was a small snake inside the water in her palm. And this snake suddenly became a small baby. And this baby was considered as Patanjali. This is a simple story. Illogical thing. Stories are always mostly illogical. And Patam means fallen. Anjali means the hand, the palm. So fallen into the palm of Gonika. That is why the name Patanjali. This story says, shows the idea that the science of yoga is such a difficult science to understand because it is about very deeper aspects of a person's mind and its function. As it is so difficult to understand or to explain, and someone who has so much great capacity to explain needs to be there to make it understandable for the people. So Ananda has 1,000 hood. Not one head is enough for portraying such a deep subject. And that is why Ananda was chosen as the narrator of yoga philosophy. Patanjali was considered as the incarnation of Ananda, having 1,000 heads. So the idea is, if he could explain something which is unexplainable, which only could be explained by 1,000 mouths, and that Patanjali could do. When you go into Patanjali's Yoga Sutra, you will understand that how precisely he could explain things which no one could explain before, about the subtle activities of the mind, what happens in the mind, and all these subtle things. That's why they say this story. Anyway, Patanjali lived in Chidambaram, there is a place inside the temple. If you visit the temple, you can see there is a place devoted for Patanjali and Thirumoolar. And also, he left his body in Rameswaram. And in Rameswaram temple, inside the temple, when you enter on the right side, there is a temple for Patanjali. And these are the two places which are associated with the life of Patanjali. And considered as a great master. And he has made few texts. The first text which he has made was on Ayurveda. That is considered as a basic text of Ayurveda. So he's a great physician, a person who is well versed in the body and Ayurveda system. His book is still taught in the universities who teach Ayurveda. Then, the second book of Patanjali is grammar. He is considered as an authority of grammar. And he made his second book of grammar. And his final book is Patanjali's Yoga Sutra. So these are his literature, his work. Patanjali is a great psychologist. He can be considered as the father of Indian psychology. Patanjali's Yoga Sutra is a basic psychology work. It is studying about the mind. Sutra means thread. Like you tie small flowers on a thread. And a thread leads somewhere. It connects with something. So when we read Yoga Sutra, you need to always have the connection with the previous sutra. And it is a continuation. The first sutra is connected with the second sutra, the third sutra, like that the flower is fixed on a thread, like making a garland. So sutras are leading to something very deep about ourselves. His Yoga Sutra has four chapters. This is called Four Chapters of Freedom. And how to get rid of your mind to make yourself free. The first stanza, the first chapter of Patanjali's Yoga Sutra is called Samadhi Pada, the chapter of integration. How to integrate yourself with the ultimate. And when you are looking there is a block that the practitioners can see, that is the mind itself. So to get into integration, you have to study the mind, understand the mind, to stay with the mind in the very present moment of time the mind is existing, coming, and then understand it fully. Then you master the mind can be dropped. The mind will be at your beck and call. Now we are at the beck and call of the mind. So when you come to that kind of a sharpness, you can get into integration. Integration means union. And the first chapter of Patanjali's Yoga Sutra is called Samadhi Pada. Then the second chapter of Patanjali's Yoga Sutra is called Sadhana Pada. It's the chapter of practice. Then he proposes how to get into the union. That is Sadhana Pada. And then when you do your practices, what are the faculties that you get into? What happens in your mind? And what are the subtle things that happens in you? And the changes that happens in you? And you get into some kind of paranormal possibilities, which is there in the human mind. And the third chapter that deals with the vibhuti, means paranormal possibilities, is called Vibhuti Pada. And then the final chapter, which is called Kaivalya Pada, the chapter of liberation. To get into Kaivalya, to get into freedom, as depicted in the last chapter, lies in the first chapter, in the first word of the Yoga Sutra. And now, Atha and now. So we need to have that focus to get into the very sharpness of observation to see what is happening now. If we don't have that sharpness, it's very difficult to understand what's going on in the mind.